Have you ever thought of leaving the diaspora to come reside in Africa? Then this is all you have to know before you take that move.
This is Dab Central, the most handsome, yakable, Africanicious, adrenaline pumping, Efizi Pawon husband. And as usual, I have beside me my only sweet Porero Sugarlicious hot baby girl.
I'm Jacquet Toluani Cetro, and it's a pleasure having you on Cetro's blog of the Cetro's family. If you're not yet subscribed, please subscribe and press the notification bell. And a thank you to all our supporters and patrons. You can be part of our patrons for as low as $3 per month. So, what are we going to be discussing today? We're going to be discussing what is pertinent and relevant to all Africans in diaspora. So, if you're there, you might have to take a chair and come closer and listen through, because in this video, you're going to really know things that will help you move.
And there could be no better set of persons to tell you all that you need to know about coming to Africa by those that are what are 100% residing here. You follow us and you learn from our mistake, and that will really help you.
Okay, number one to start with, if you ever think of moving to your motherland, which is Africa, it's a courageous thing that you can do. We have 14 points itemized here that you just have to follow through one after the other to check your list if you're really ready to come to Africa.
And the number one is the fact that you need to rediscover yourself, because if you are coming to Africa, please hold on, just calm down. Don't just jump to that plane. You need to sit back and ask yourself some pertinent questions which will help you to rediscover who you really are. And to now ask yourself, the person that you are currently, does that personality of yours match with the location you are coming to in Africa? Because Africa is entirely a different ozone that you just need to be sure that you are ready to fit in. And that is where you need to ask yourself, who are you? Are you egocentric? Are you full of yourself? Are you just concerned about yourself? Or are you people loving? Or you are just the kind of person that can fit in into a society by calming down and not being too showy? Then Africa is for you if you are what? If you are on the calm side, or what we call the cool, calm and collected.
Okay, and having considered yourself, the number two point you have to consider before taking that move is what? Research into the particular country you were coming into in Africa.
You can never go wrong when it comes to researching into the particular country you are coming into in Africa. Please look at the choice of word, particular country that you are coming into in Africa. Forget about all those mongo jumbo stories that you have been told, and people are addressing Africa as if it's just one country. Mind you, open your mind. Africa is having 54 different countries with well-spiced numerous thousands and thousands, if not millions, of culture. And as such, you need to just sit down and do a proper research by doing what? By knowing the place you are going to, the prevalent culture that is there, the way and manner that they perceive you, their welcoming spirit or not, because in Africa, we still have different grade of what? Welcoming spirit to visitors. And as such, you need to be what? You need to research into the culture of where you are going to, the food of the people that you are going to mix with, and
their language is also very important. You have to take cognizance of this.
And when I say that you must research into the particular place, the particular country you are coming to reside in Africa, I really meant that. In terms of food, in terms of culture, in terms of language. And the language that we are talking about here, you need to learn even before coming, even before jumping through the plane, you need to just learn the little means of conversation, because it will help you. You will send me a thank you message when you actually do this. Just, you need to spice up yourself with how to greet, how to respond to greeting, how to ask basic questions, how much is this and that, because that will be a template, a ready-made template to welcome you into such society. And aside that, you might just be thinking of what? linking up with some person that can really teach you this nitty-gritty. If you are thinking of coming to Africa, Nigeria precisely, and you want to come to the western part of Africa, which happens to be the center of commerce, where we call Lagos, then you might as well reach out to us. We can be able to give you a little a little bit of training in the Yoruba dialect that will prepare you ahead before jumping the plane. Please don't jump the plane. Learn the conversation.
Then you also need to know about the visa application, the season to come in, the business capacity of the country you're going into, because this will actually help further your prospects in whatever you
know. I just laugh when I saw some persons, you are coming into Africa. Okay, what country in Africa? You are looking at yourself with somebody as somebody that have business mindset, and you want to come into Africa, and you are thinking of going into a country that the population is not large enough to really give you the kind of market that you want. Absolutely. Then you are really making a mistake from the onset. If you pick a country like Nigeria, where we have over 200 million capacity, as in over 200 million people, let me advise you, we are larger than that. So, but at least for the paperwork, we have over 200 million people as compared to any other African country that might be 1.7 million. I'm not discouraging you from other African countries, but I'm just saying that if your prospect is large, you should be looking at bigger, as in countries in Africa whose population is larger, whose demand will also be what larger. Maybe based on my economics background, you might need to research well, because this will determine how much of your business investment yield, if I can put it that way. Then when you talk about season, in Africa, we especially in Nigeria, we have the rainy season and the dry season. So you might as well look into that, because it affects your inflow. Because during the rainy season, if you are coming in, you might just be thinking of how you move about with umbrella, of which it will reduce the number of time you'll be out there to really study where you are moving into.
And number three, when you want to come down to Africa, you have to think of what respects, or however you want to call it, because Africa is a continent that is built on cultural value of respect, as in it's a value that Africans take with high esteem. You have to respect the elders, you respect their religious belief. That's another thing. Africans are so religious, so you just have to respect the elders, you respect is reciprocal. You respect, when you respect people, it's not just that guy, Africans.
Let me just come in there. You know, in Africa, if there is any first thing you need to put in your traveling bag, is the fact that you need to spell out the word respect in your mannerism. The way you talk to anybody that is even a year older than you matters here. This is not the hey guys. You don't come here and tell people hey guys, especially when they are older than you. That will just be what? It will be flushing you down the toilet, because you have already missed the flight ticket. So when we talk of respect, we are talking of respect for religion, respect for elders, and respect for the local laws in the particular community you are settling in. This will really be a very good foundation that will enjoy, that will make you to have a smooth ride on the continent of Africa. Because if there is anything Africans don't joke with, they don't joke with respect. Even if somebody is older than you by just 1 year, it deserves some respect. So you don't just come up with hey guys, just see elders, maybe elders are somewhere, and say hey guys, chop knuckle. Wow, you are going to be flushed out of that community.
And number four, before coming to Africa, you also have to get in contact with what? A trusted local guide.
This is very, very paramount. This is something you can't do without. If you miss out on this, you will lose money, you will lose valuables, and you can even lose your life. I'm not trying to scare you, but I'm just trying to tell you that who is going to be your local guide determines to a large extent how you are going to enjoy your stay in any African community. If your local guide is a cheat, sorry, you've catch the wrong boat. If your local guy is trustworthy, so your life is going to have a smooth sail. And how do you understand that somebody is going to be able to be fitting in into either the good guy or the bad guy? It's based on what I've told you before. You learn the language before jumping the plane. And when you get down here or wherever you are going to, pretend as if you don't know what they are saying, that you don't know a little thing about what they are saying, so that you can use the opportunity to test those your local guide. Because at the end of the day, by the time you would have subjected them to some test level, you'll be able to say, okay, oh, this one is a very good guide, honest and truthful, and you still continue to be on your watch, because human beings do change. Then please take note of this. Don't be offended. Don't just think because somebody is religious that is going to be trustworthy or faithful. No, some persons do not have that.
Most persons in Africa have confused religion with integrity. Yeah. Religion and integrity ought to be well aligned together, but no, that's not real in Africa. We just have to shout it out to you. You can see people that are so religious, that mark my word,
and so
dubious, and they are cheats. So don't let people deceive you with religion.
God bless you. God bless you. And your dollar is leaving. God bless you. Oh, God is by your side. And your dollar is leaving.
Whatever the religion they practice doesn't matter.
Yeah. No.
It's all about, oh, I've seen people practice whatever religion. And they are honest. They have integrity. They are truthful. So it doesn't exempt any religion. All the religions, I tell you, all in Africa, forget it. Forget religion. It's different. Honesty and integrity, it's a virtue people have.
And because of the hunger level, in Africa, a lot of persons have sold out their religious belief just for the paper that was marked by some persons to be spent. So please, kindly ensure you have a proper local guide, because it will save you money. What you are supposed to buy for $1, you will not buy for $50, because if you miss it, what you are supposed to get for 50 cents, you will get it for $1,000.
And it will save you your life. And whoever your local guide is, learn to keep your secrets.
Mm-hmm.
Don't just expose, I have this, that, I want to, I'm going to set up this. You don't tell locals everything you're coming to do in Africa. Don't just say, I'm going to set up this. No, please keep your secrets. And that's taking us to the fifth step. Do you understand? You just have to pay a visit first. Pay a visit first before coming down. Pay a casual visit, like 2 to 3 weeks, to test the waters, to look at where you're coming to know the look and feel of how the place and the people are, what you want to do there, do a needs assessment, look at the people. And
let me tell you, if you are jumping into the plane the first time and you are thinking, oh, I'm black, I'm coming to Africa, you'll be like the part two of coming to America, because you will fly back. Because in few weeks, in few days, you'll be drenched. So for you not to make that mistake, don't just jump into the plane and be thinking that you are just coming to a side pool somewhere to exist for a long time. No, you really need to do your study, and part of your study is to come in, spend like 2 to 3 weeks to understudy the particular region, the particular place that you are coming to settle down in. And it is during this, your 2 to 3 weeks period, that you'll be able to move around, understudy what kind of businesses that can thrive here in Africa. For example, if you are coming to Nigeria and you wish to reach out to us, I tell you, you need to plan coming first for 2 to 3 weeks. We'll go together, we'll go out, you'll see places, you will see businesses that people are doing. And let me tell you, the funnest stuff is that the cheapest business setup gives you the best form of returns. We have a whole list of businesses that you can do here in Africa that you'll be shocked, because your businesses will just be growing like McDonald's. As in, you'll be having you'll be having centers here and there without missing it. So for you to achieve this, you just need to come, survey the land, sit in physically yourself, and I'm telling you, you'll be able to make up your mind whether you are in the right place or in the wrong place. Now, number six is, what problem are you coming to solve in Africa? Let me just tell you that if you are coming to Africa to come and look for job, you've jumped into the wrong bus. If you are coming to Africa, you must have a problem that you are coming to solve. And I tell you, it is that problem-solving nature of yours that will give you the best of all returns in life. And you know what? In Africa, numerous problems are there waiting for scarce men and women that will be there
with special solutions. It might just be as little as nail challenges that people have. Some persons have nail health challenges, and maybe you have a solution that can solve that, that can create wealth for you. I'm just saying the listing. People also have water challenge, and maybe you've been able to discover something that will solve that challenge and you create a solution, man, you'll be flying. There are so many challenges.
Or you have the opportunity to mentor people into creativity. I tell you, people will flock your door and they will be the one disturbing you that they want to pay for your what, for your services. Or you are such talented in craft development, in preferring simple business, even as air fixing, air whatever problems, and you know, these bumps that is usually noticeable on men's back and the likes. I'm just citing these few examples. There are numerous of challenges in Africa that if you prefer the solutions to it, you will not be running after money. Money and comfort will be running after you. Please note that if you are coming to Africa with the mindset of solving a problem, that will inform you setting up a very tidy business that will really, really outlast you and the generations to come. And so you will have a fun time in Africa, because even the government, the locals, everybody around you will see you as a solution, and as such they will come around you to support you, because they now see that you are not just one of those takers, but you are a giver of solutions to challenges.
Yeah, and the number seven thing you have to think of, very, very important before moving to Africa, is that please, when moving to Africa, think of coming to own your own house. Here in Africa, it's very easy to own a house. So you just got to come with that mentality, because whatever business you're setting up, whatever thing you're doing in Africa, if you don't own a house, you've not started.
You are just playing. Mm-hmm. Let me come into that. When we say own your own house or your home in Africa, I tell you, once you are able to do this, if this is the first thing you achieve in your stay in Africa, you can continue to relax and enjoy yourself, because in the process, you discover that you can even begin to make extra cash by letting out parts of your what, of your properties to people to stay in, because housing challenge is much in Africa. And as a result of that, anybody that attempts or have a group of attempts to become land owner or house owner is at the edge of breakthrough. And talk of this, you can successfully run a very low cost business when you own your house, as you can do your businesses right from the comfort of your home, especially with this present scenario where everybody can do their business right from the comfort of their toilet.
After owning your own house, or even before you think of the location where you're going to own your own house, number eight point you have to think of is what? You have to think of security. Security, mark my words. That is so important in Africa. You have to think of security, and the security of the place where you are even to own that, your own house or business.
Please let me quickly tell you this, that if you are coming to Africa, please note, there is a way we speak in Nigeria, there is a way we speak in Africa, there is a way the locals speak, and as such, the way you are going to be speaking when you get to any part of Africa is going to be pronouncedly different. Differentosia. Okay, it's going to be seriously different, so they will be able to pick you out that, oh, this person doesn't belong here. And as a result of that, a lot of Africans have the mentality that anybody coming from outside the country, you are coming with hard currency. And as a result of this, when you are settling down, you need to have security structure up here. And as such, there are some places that you should not even try to live in just for your own security. There are some other places that is okay for you. Let me cite an example. When I was working in the banking sector, I was trying to minimize costs. So I got a very good
apartment
in a very, very low class area. And at the end of the day, I discovered that I am not properly placed, because anything I do, hundreds of eyes are just watching and looking. I'm parking the car, I'm coming out, and there was a day that they actually came, but because of security, they were not able to get into the house. Immediately after, not long after that, we have to park out of that environment. So please, and that's why so many people from the diaspora, when they are coming to a place like Lagos, they tend to move to the island. But let me tell you, island is very expensive, it's good, but there are some specific places in the mainland also that are very, very security tight and 100% far better than the island. Because on the island, maybe one of these days we'll talk about the island and mainland.
Yeah.
On the island, you live there seasonally. There will come a time that water, rain, and they say
no, you don't go into it. So it's just watch out for it.
Yeah.
The island and mainland experience, yeah, here in Nigeria, Lagos State.
Yeah.
So that's it.
Number 9, you need to consider this when coming into Africa, and it's what? Ensure you settle down into a community. What do I mean by this? Don't settle into a class of your own in which you are disconnected from the community, because Africa happens to be a communal environment. We do things together, we exchange ideas together, we share information together. Because if you are dissociating yourself from the community that is hosting you, I tell you, when there will be an alert about a pending problem, you will not know. You will just wake up and you are left all blank. So if you are coming into Africa, ensure that you have good rapport with the people in the community. And as such, that's why you need to have bracing yourself with the language prevalent in the community. You are coming, you are seeing somebody that is selling something on the road, you are greeting them, you are talking to them, hey, how are you? And you try to speak their language. How do I pronounce this? Let them make fun of you. From the way they are making fun of you, they'll be like, oh, this guy is actually a good man. And from there, they'll be able to give you first-hand information. Even when some group of persons might want to do anything against you, they will rise up for your defense.
And number 10 is straightforward. You don't have to come with your what? Foreign appliances, because of the voltage right here in Africa.
Majority of the appliances you might probably be bringing down into Africa from America, from Europe, and the likes of them, they are going to be busted by the power surge here in Africa. Unless if you must do that, then you must invest heavily in bringing along with it, or you get a step down here, voltage step down, numerous voltage step down for them to work properly here. Otherwise, within few days, few weeks, everything will just be what? Will be blown up.
And the 11th point you need to consider is you don't have to be flamboyant.
Please kindly note that the African community in which you are trying to settle down in, there are numerous persons around that might not be economically supported as you are. And as such, living a flamboyant life can create a wrong impression about you, as if you have it all, and they might be tempted to what? To come after you. So to prevent that, please stay humble, stay simple. Number 12, you need to avoid being too nice in the sense that whatever transactions you are carrying out in Africa, ensure that you capture it in video, because it gives that mindset that whatever that you are doing or they are doing or the third party is doing with you, your friends all over the world can see what is going on, and that will be an extra precaution. And also ensure that everything that involves business is legally backed. Both parties are signing to it, there is a witness to it, and everything will go on smoothly. Please don't overtrust anybody with your hard-earned cash.
Yeah, 13th thing you have to make sure you think of is that in Africa, you can't just come and start going clubbing like that, because the clubs right here in Africa are not like the ones you have over there. No.
If club happens to be your church over there, please take note that in Africa is a different ball game. Most of the time, people that come into Africa, they get into trouble by meeting with the wrong persons at some of these so-called clubs, because you just need to be very, very careful. Much of responsible people in Africa don't go clubbing. So please, it's a very painful fact, but some responsible people go to club, but I'm telling you that most of the time, the possibility of meeting with the wrong set of people is actually in some of these clubs.
Very high.
Yeah.
The clubs.
Please do take note of the fact that money should not be the first thing you consider before jumping into Africa. Please don't jump the gun. You need information. You need all the 13 things I've mentioned. The last thing you need to come with is money. And when you come in with money, I've told you, come with enough money to take care of your life in terms of housing. You solve the problem of housing in Africa, you are a king. By what? Purchasing the house and taking outright ownership. Then you can think of getting a car, because your house should serve as your business center. And with that, you'll be able to save yourself the trouble of paying rent, because actually, housing in Africa, by the time you look at it, what you are going to be paying as rent in Africa 3-5 years would have bought you that same particular standard of house. And as such, please don't come to Africa if you do not have enough money to take care of you. And when you get to Africa, please make sure that you look for the right person, the right people to guide you. And please just respect the culture. Once you respect the culture, respect the people. The people of Africa, they love foreigners a lot. They will do a lot to protect a responsible foreigner. But if you are the type that is just making them see themselves as below you, or issuing out orders as if they are flies, they will show you that they are not Kunta Kinte.
And that's just it today. I want to believe you've been able to learn one or two things to add to your portfolio of knowledge before moving down to Africa. Yeah.
And if you want us to continue this series by telling you more, I would have loved to do a video on businesses they can invest into when they come to Africa. Please, if you are interested in that, you can reach out to us. And if you are interested in coming to Nigeria, if you are interested in coming to Nigeria, we'll be so glad as a family to host you and show you what and what you can do in Africa.
And that's it on today's show. We remain the Setros. Don't forget the joy therapy that cures it all. Whatever challenge you're going through, joy, your joy is your strength, and your strength is your life. So make sure you don't lose your joy. Yeah.
And before we go, please, if you're watching this video, give it a thumbs up. Share this video to all diasporan people. If there's any English like that, don't mind my English. Let me know about your Yoruba share Magboni. So, and if you want us to coach you in Yoruba, if you want us to teach you how to speak the usual Yoruba, everyday Yoruba, I'm not talking of the deep ones, the usual Yoruba that we enable you to communicate easily with people around in Nigeria, then reach out to us. We can talk up. It's not for free. It's not for free, because we can talk about that. So you pay for the training, we initiate an online training for you on how to speak the Yoruba, and by the time you get into the western part of Nigeria, you will have a smooth sale. You can reach out to the people, you can talk to people, how much is this, what's the price of pepper, what's this, you can go to the market and the like. If you leave me, I will continue. But you know what, since my wife is just telling me that we should just go and do some silent prayer, so let's get out.
Thank you so very much. Till we see you in our next video, we read the settlers. You may like to watch this video or this.